joining us now from their homes in New York and Jersey, Desus and Mero. Okay, listen, you should have known before he was President Obama, he lived in Chicago and played ball with the best trash talker ever, Michael Jordan. Desus, what were you thinking when you came up against that?
I came in fully respectable. I'm like, you're a former president. I'm going to show you the utmost respect. And we didn't get President Obama. We got Barry from the Shy, and he took those kill shots. It was like when your uncle posts up on you. I couldn't say nothing. I had to catch my breath for a second.
You had to catch. I mean, listen, first of all, I'm so happy to finally have you both on the show. This is so fun. It's about time. Meryl, you know.
This is major.
I feel like when I watch you, this is an extension of summer school with the two guys who kept getting in trouble, but finally somehow somebody talked sense into them and they got their life together. Is that the proper explanation?
Bullseye.
Yes.
Bullseye. You know what I mean? Like, we're just two regular dudes from the Bronx who, you know, apply our life experiences to what we talk about. You know what I mean? And that's like, to quote Glenn Close, a breath of effing fresh air.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So, like, you know, it's really like there's nothing like TV. It's nothing like us on TV. And that feels great because to have, you know, I know it's like a corny saying or whatever, but like representation matters. It really does. So, like, you know, for little kids, like, you know, growing up like us, coming up from the same hoods, immigrant backgrounds, all that good stuff, to see us doing what we do and like, not taking those shorts and just going back and forth with the former president of the United States.
Well, I will tell you this. A lot of people may not think, I know you think, okay, your guys are doing your show and you're doing it different. As a former summer school suspended kid, D student occasionally, I understand how it is to get your life in order once somebody tells you to get it together.
Yes.
So we're kind of in the same suspension club. Desus, I got to say, you got your name. As I understand it, you were kind of a computer geek around the house, your Jamaican family.
Yes.
They called you Jesus because you could fix everything. Is that true?
Hey. Yes, that is. I was actually retelling someone that story because I was so good with computers. They were just like, you're just Jesus with a D, which is a very lazy nickname. But I was really nice with computers. But being nice in the hood with computers just meant I was able to put MP3s on people's iPods.
Oh.
So it wasn't that major.
You weren't Bill Gates in the garage. You were just turning on a few.
I was just illegal downloading MP3s and everyone loved it.
Meryl, it's crazy to watch you guys because I think what is so refreshing also is that you have that kid at heart energy, but you're a father of four.
Yeah.
How do you explain your vibe to the kids? Did your wife say, listen, man, you're not a teenager. You're a dad of four. What you and Desus do on the show, that stays on the show.
Right.
You know what? She, like, it's funny, like, to quote Drake, she knew what it was when she signed up. Oh. You know what I mean? Like, like, when we first started dating, like, this is like 10 plus years in the making, Tamron. Like, so, like, this is not, you know what I mean? Like, we didn't just meet like a year ago. So I was this guy, you know, making $15,000 a year, making however many dollars a year. I'm Mero all day, no days off. You know what I mean? Like, so she knew. Like, she's just like, and she has this thing where she calls it annoying mode. She's like, oh, you're in annoying mode. Like, flip back up off me. Like, stop grabbing my butt. We in the kitchen. I'm trying to make pancakes. You know what I'm saying? Like, chill, relax.
Oh, like, she says you're in annoying mode. Well, listen, you're never in an annoying mode when you're doing your show. Looking back at your history, first starting out with just the audio podcast, I was so intrigued, Desus, by the story of when you were just doing the podcast, people didn't see your face, and there was a rumor that you were white. You had to go on camera to prove to people in the beginning that you were actually black. You were like the masked singer before the show. What What is the backstory there?
Not in a good way, like the masked singer. It was a little scary because apparently when people were waiting for me because people were just like, there's no way this guy could be black. The things he's tweeting are not coming from a black person. And when they thought I was white, everyone just like unreleased their drafts and were dragging me and just calling me all types of like insults and slurs. And I just laughed because I was like, yo, we got a video coming out. Y'all gonna feel pretty stupid. Y'all gonna want to delete those tweets.
Because they thought, because that's really, Mero, that's the beginning of where you had the audio podcast, but it was also this social media buzz around these two guys from the Bronx who were really, and I'll put it the way people talk, you were talking trash about everything on social media. And you started to get this huge following. And it ultimately blew up into this TV world, this unmasking. And here you are, two men of color who grew up in the Bronx, not what a lot of people thought when they started reading the tweets.
There was absolutely no one that could look back at our tweets and be like, these guys are going to end up with a show on premium cable in a couple of years. Like, even we didn't know that.
They should have known. They should have known. They should have seen the vision, because when the whole Desus is white conspiracy happened, that was just, I posted a picture of a fan, and I just said, Desus versus Mero in the flesh, finally. And then, like, it got picked up by, like, remember Gawker? It got picked up by Gawker, and I was just like, yo, oh, is this viral marketing?
So basically, sounds like you two were diabolical geniuses who stumbled into something incredible.